turn on the light. So, good morning. In Douglas Adams' Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy, the very first episode, right at the beginning, the entire start of the story, Arthur Dent finds himself in a pub before noon trying to down 6 pints of lager on the behest of his best friend of 16 years, who he has just found out is an alien, and is trying to get him off of the Earth before it is destroyed to make way for a hyperspace bypass. Now, his day is already discombobulated because, in an interesting parallel, not unintentional, obviously, his house was about to be demolished for a normal terrestrial bypass. So his literal home and then his figurative home are both being destroyed on the same day. The second part of that, he's not exactly aware of. He's completely befuddled by all the things that are going on. And as his friend is not telling him that they're about to get on a spaceship, leave the Earth before it is destroyed, he's never going to come back, and he shouldn't worry about his house because he needs to drink his 6 pints of beer before they teleport up and hitchhike, ergo the name, Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy. His response to the massive confusion that's happening is, "This must be Thursday. I never could get the hang of Thursdays." And today is Thursday. It's also the closest Thursday to Towel Day, which was May 25th, which is the birthday of Douglas Adams. Towel Day being, of course, how nerds commemorate the birth of Douglas Adams and their love and joy for both The Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy and Dirk Gently's Holistic Detective Agency. That's a bit of a mouthful. Now, I don't like Thursdays, because after the unpaid day, I go into work and I will open up my email box and it will explode with 3 to 4 times the number of emails I would find in there on a Monday. So my Thursdays are actually worse than my Mondays, which is interesting because my Monday follows 2 days off and my Thursday only follows 1 day off. But that 1 day is a day that a lot of people are working, and for some reason, I think they've clued into the fact that I'm not there, because there will be a whole lot of stuff that they spent all yesterday dumping in my inbox, and then conversations, and all of this, and I have to go through every line of it, because somewhere on the 5th email of a 10-email exchange in the 7th paragraph is going to be my name and an instruction for something I need to do on a chain of emails that have absolutely otherwise nothing to do with me. So my first hour and a half to 2 hours is going to be doing this today. And then whatever fires have been dumped on me, that will determine the rest of my day. Whether it's just firefighting days, whether whatever plans I had going in are completely tossed out the window for these now important things that I will draft critical letters for, send to people who have to approve and sign them, and then wait probably until Monday before I can get rid of them, if I'm lucky. Now, I was having dreams about work last night. That's never a good sign. It's never a good sign. But before I go off any farther, there's a little bit of housekeeping I need to do. There's a couple of videos that... There are a couple of videos that I've had... that were recorded that I haven't used, that I haven't found a way of using, and I haven't made a point of using, and I'm going to make a point of using them now. So, the Vlog a Day for May Challenge presents Puppets with Trudy, Part 1.
Hey Leo, we heard you were doing really not that well financially, so we took up a collection for you. Here you go. No thanks, man. I've got my pride. Hey Tusk, have you guys been all vaccinated? No, we don't have to. We've got herd immunity.
So I hope you enjoyed that. Actually been, is it almost 4 or 5 days now that I've had that and I haven't gotten it in. The plan is I'm going to be cycling home. There's no rain expected. It'll be in the mid-teens, so it should be pleasant. It's not even supposed to be terribly windy, so this could be quite a different change from the 3 previous commute days where I have barely had the energy to sweat. I'm going to cut to a picture here because this is literally the funniest tree hugger photo I've ever seen in my entire life. It has to do with the BC clear cutting protests, which, you know, you would have thought by now somebody would have figured out they don't work. They don't work. You know, somebody on Facebook shared a picture of what BC looks like from the sky, and only the highways have, you know, thick, lush trees. As soon as you get like 100 meters away, it's clear cut. They've had protests about this in British Columbia my entire lifetime, so they don't work. But cut to this, because this is literally, this sums up both millennials, and socialists and tree huggers and everything right here. This one picture for the Instagram overdramatic. You don't understand me. This is it. So here we go. Wasn't that awesome? Yeah, I thought so too. That is the funniest tree hugger photo I've ever seen in my entire life. In fact, I might make it my screensaver for a while. That's how funny I think that is. And it's not that I'm all in favor of doing something. But, you know, the something that happens, it happens at the policy level. If you don't get engaged in politics, if you don't get engaged in the politics of power and then influence that, then you're just wasting your time. You're just a protest party. And protest parties accomplish nothing. The NDP was the least effective opposition during the Harper majority of any opposition in the history of Canada, because they're just a protest party. They have nothing actually to offer. And, oh, it's not like they don't have a lot of ideas. None of them would work. The Tooth Fairy is more grounded in reality than Jagmeet Singh. That's the end of that one. Meanwhile, in entertainment, oh, how's that for a segue? Okay, so Aries, someone you usually get along with quite well could be in a bad mood today. Rest assured, it has nothing to do with what you may or may not have done. So don't take it personally. Stay out of their way if you can. It will pass. That last bit is my strategy most of the time. You know, like, all right, you know, who pissed in your cornflakes? Which was a phrase I got from the first person I ever worked full-time for. Who pissed in your cornflakes? Hey, Cancer, by all means, enjoy your big ideas and big ambitions, but don't expect others to agree with what you're planning. Either you'll have to go it alone or wait a few days until they've caught up with your progressive way of thinking. And then you can change the world! Okay, so now it's time for the second of Puppets with Trudy.
So, Zoe, is it zebra or zebra? Well, Aggie, do you say ape or ape? Oh, I get it. I say it doesn't care. Doesn't matter at all. Oh, bite me. Oh, on second thought, no. Don't do that.
Yeah, it's just network time filler right now. I swear to God, I'm so done with this vlog. And of course, part of the problem is, you know, if you remember from yesterday's vlog, oh yeah, I'm going to get the edit done on this episode. It was like, oh my God, it was like 8 o'clock and I'm still working on this thing. And I just barely got to the point where I have almost completed the rough edit. The problem is I'm satirizing a show that has a live audience. So now I have to go in and I have to insert the sounds of an audience. And that's killing me. The bits I've done so far are like, oh my God, this is tedious. This is tedious. Laugh tracks are tedious. But it has to be there because you've got a puppet saying something, aha! And then waiting for a laugh. And there's no laugh. And it just looks, well, I can't say ridiculous. It's a puppet show. But yeah, oy. Thank you. the gold from the original series. Kirk, the first color tunic killed on Star Trek wasn't a red shirt. I'm not sure if I touched. Stay away from Howie. After cycling home, you have to lift your bike up, so back tire goes there, front tire goes there, and then you have to reach under the handlebars in order to push that closed, and then add the level of difficulty that my bike is in the corner, and there's no way of getting around it, so I have to go under the bars to reach over to close it, presuming that's not too difficult because I'm holding the bike up while I'm doing it. So I'm effectively shouldering into that. And then I have to do it a second time to put the lock on it. I mean, you know, 10 out of 10 for space saving where space is saved, but minus several million for usability after a long bike ride. I'm tired as it is. I don't need to be wrestling that bullshit. And then add to that, now that I've stopped moving, and I'm no longer outside, so I don't have a breeze going over me. Now I start sweating. Because it was only about 15 on the way home, which was actually really good. And more importantly, not too windy. So ideal cycling weather. I think I managed to maintain 7th gear for a lot of it, which is actually 14th. And only a few times did I have to go down to 3. So, on the whole, very good ride. Although I'm not fixing that until I get home. Weird phone mask in the lobby, just wandering around at the elevator. So, bye!
And that's the vlog of day for May 27, 2021. I hope you had a good day wherever you are. See you tomorrow. Bye.